Oh, well, Chris, I have some bad news for you. All the tires have to be renewed. With the right air pressure, you have come much farther with these tires.
No, wait, we were about to go on vacation. You're telling me I can't drive with these?
Nope, not with these tires.
Oh, no. As you can see, I'm not ready for my vacation, but I hope you're ready for the garage. You know, I could be on vacation right now, riding some waves, but I'm here. Why? Due to my worn old tire. And I do wonder nowadays, with all the technology we have, we can send massive amounts of data to space to another person within seconds. But a worn tire is holding me back from going on vacation. How can that be? And how can we avoid this in the future? Let's find out with the help of our expert. His name is Christoph Baga, and he is a development engineer at Continental. Christoph, great to have you.
Hi, Chris.
How are you doing today?
Fine, you?
Yeah, good. Now tell us, how can we avoid, you know, the wrong tire pressure, tread depth that we have to check every now and then, which was my problem?
Yeah, in the future, we need intelligent tires that have sensors in and have the possibility to monitor the tire status all the time and give feedback to the driver or to the vehicle or to somebody else.
So you say this like you already have a solution.
Yeah, we have a technology concept.
Well, can you show it to us?
Yeah, of course. The second.
Look at this. Christoph, you guys are all magicians at Continental, aren't you?
Sometimes.
So what are we going to be doing with all this stuff, though?
With this, I want to demonstrate how we make the tire rubber conductive to use the rubber in the tire as a rubber wire.
Okay, wait a minute. Conductive means?
You can transmit electrical energy through the rubber.
I thought so. Isn't rubber an isolating material, though?
Normally, yes, but here I have a special kind of rubber with special ingredients, filler materials, which make this rubber conductive.
Sorry, Christoph, but this looks like a simple piece of rubber to me.
Yeah. Here you can see we transmit electric energy through this rubber to make the LED illuminate.
No way. So you mean electricity is actually transmitted?
Yeah, we're closing here the electric circuit and the LED is on. Here we have an even more complex signal. It's music.
That's what I like. So Christoph, what did you do?
Here, I can show to you. It's really rubber. There are no wires
that
in it.
That is crazy. This is the new way of DJing, ladies and gentlemen. So how about, let's say, a more dangerous situation. I run over a nail or something like
that. Yeah, here we have an easy experiment. So you have here a sandwich of a conductive layer, an isolating layer, and again a conductive layer. Mm-hmm. What you can see here, it's all okay. We have no puncture. So in case we have a puncture, you see.
So
we
it switches. Detected. Which means, once again, the tire is actually telling me, hey, something's wrong.
We can detect a puncture before we have an air pressure loss.
That is awesome.
This sandwich, you can see here as well in the tire. Here is the conductive layer, the yellow isolating layer, and again a conductive layer. This sandwich, which we see here, is also implemented here in this tire.
Pretty amazing what tires can do nowadays.
Yeah.
Now, the only thing missing is, let's say, if the tire would, you know, switch to, you know, winter tires or summer tires according to the weather time. That'd be fantastic.
We have a technology concept for this.
No way.
Wait a second.
And you did it again. Christoph, you gotta show me this trick one day.
Yeah, maybe.
But first tell us, what is this?
This is our technology concept, ContiAdapt, which adapts the tire footprint to different road conditions automatically.
When you're talking about footprint, what do you mean?
It's the contact area between the tire and the road where we transmit the forces.
I get it. So what do we have now?
And at the moment, we have the setup for wet conditions.
Uh-huh.
So we have a narrow rim width and a high inflation pressure. This leads to a smaller footprint with high contact pressure.
Okay, so what happens if I get into a snowy situation?
Yeah, in this case, we widen the rim and we decrease the inflation pressure.
That is cool.
So we get additional zones in the pattern into the footprint to generate additional traction, for example, on snow or on ice.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
what you see in the graphic is a nice footprint of the tire, mm-hmm. which is, so to say, a picture from underneath.
Yeah, from underneath.
So I gotta get me one of these before I go on my next vacation. So, one, two, three. Thank you very much, Christoph, for joining us. Thank you for tuning in, and be sure to tune in again next time for a new episode of The Garage. I'm off to vacation. How about you?
Not yet.
Not yet?
Mm-hmm.